Hi everyone, this is Ravi Kumar Singh, Assistant Professor at International School of Management, Patna. So today we are going to discuss what logistic management is. So for today we are going to cover five topics. First one is origin and meaning of logistics, definition of logistics management, feature of logistics, scope of logistics, and finally 6R framework. So if we talk about the origin of this word logistic, this word has been found in one of the book written by Baron Henry, who was a general in French army. So he wrote the book The Art of War. So this word was first appeared in this book The Art of War by Baron Henry, a general in French army. The English meaning of this word is art of moving or quartering and supplying the troops. Quartering means stationary, putting the army at a certain place. So this word has also connection in Greek and Latin language. So different authors has used this word. In Greek, the word logistikos was used, and in Latin it is used as logisticus, and in both the words have same meaning, and it was a science of computing and calculating. So for be it Greek and origin, as both have very similar kind of words. They in Greek and Latin both use similar type of words, and logisticos or logisticus both mean science of computing and calculating. So if we talk about this use of this word in the sense of business, so in business organization, this word means the production and distribution of distribution function of a firm. So from the point of origin of any product or any service, and from the and till the point of consumption of any product or service, this logistic plays a role of connector, and it moves the product or services from the point of origin to point of consumption. So in military context, it was the word logistics means supply of troops with food, armament, troops, arms and ammunition, troop transportation, and all those things. So in business organization, it is movement of resources from the point of origin to point of consumption. And in business, in public organization, the word logistics means all service management things like garbage collection, mail delivery, your speed post, everything where pickup, delivery, and movement, storage, all these things are involved. So now if we talk about the definition of this word logistics, so according to H.W. Newman, logistics are concerned with having the right resources available at the right time at the right place. I'm repeating it once again. Logistics are concerned with having the right resources available at the right place at the right time. So here you can find three rights: right resources, right place, and right time. It means we have to place our resources at the right at the right time, and the resources must be appropriate one. So what is required? The resources which is required must be there at the right place and at the time of requirement. So we can say that logistics is all about time related positioning of resources. So according to Council of Logistic Management, if we define logistic, it will go like, logistic is the process of planning, implementing, and the process of planning, implementing, and controlling the efficient, cost-effective flow and storage of raw materials, work in process inventory, finished good, and related information from the point of origin to point of consumption. Point of consumption for the purpose of conforming the customer's requirement. So from this definition, we can jot down the features of logistics. So logistic ensures, the first feature of logistic is that logistic ensures an uniform and scheduled flow of goods such as raw materials, work in process, and finished goods. Second is, it possesses the ability of meeting customers and other stakeholders' expectation. And third one is, it ensures availability of right product at the right time, at the right place, in the right quantity, at the right place. After a few slides, we will discuss a 7R framework which is based on these things. So, and the fourth feature is, logistic enables the organizations to provide the best possible customer service at the lowest possible cost. Fifth is, it is an integration of various managerial functions for the optimum usage of resources. Sixth one is, logistic enhances productivity and profitability. So these are the features of logistics. So logistics is a tool to gain competitive advantage. In fact, so if we talk about the scope of logistics, so the first scope of logistics is, it covers everything which gives superior value to the customers. Value means the difference between the ratio of cost and benefit. So all, everything which enhances the value for a customer, the involvement of logistic is immense there. So yes, its scope is very much visible from the point of origin to point of consumption. So from the point of origin, the product must be moved to enable the consumption. So where movement is involved, logistic is involved. Where storage is involved, logistic is involved. Where inventory is involved, logistic is involved. Where order processing is involved, logistic is involved. So these are the functions through which logistic gives superior value to the customers. So third scope is, logistic is a tool for developing competitiveness. So it gives competitive advantage. We will, in coming sessions, we will discuss about what is competitive advantage. This concept was proposed by Michael Porter, so we will discuss in detail. So here, the scope of logistics, if you summarize these things, the scope of logistics covers the management of material procurement. Procurement means purchasing, so that is point of origin. Now the manufacturing processes and the delivery of finished good so that it can be consumed. So from the involvement, logistics is involved from the point of origin. Then after the whole processes involved in manufacturing and then the delivery of finished good to the customer. Now the last thing is the 7R framework of customer satisfaction. So if you'll find it here, there are seven R's. R means right. R here means right. So seven kind of right things are done under logistics. So right cost, right time, right relation, right service, right place, right quality, right quantity. So all these three things, all these 7 hours all together delivers satisfaction to customer. And in the delivery of satisfaction, logistics plays a vital role. So if we talk about right cost, so right cost means the expected cost of customers. So if our cost of operation comes down, an organization will be able to meet that expectation easily. Or even a customer will be delighted if customer is able to find something better than the expectation. So right time. So here, right means the expectation of customers. So customer is expecting a delivery in 7 weeks. It is only possible when we are using that kind of facility which can fulfill that expectation. So logistics is involved there. Right relation between the customer, company, the product. So to establish this relation, logistics plays a very vital role. Then right services means expected services. So when services means one, when a customer is trying to or purchases the product. Second, after purchasing the product, the requirement of services. So for both, logistics has its role. Then right place means goods or services available at the expected place. So a customer is expecting availability of product in a nearby store. That is only possible when a company's distribution system is so robust, so strong that goods and services are available at that point. Then right quantity. Always customers want goods in right quantity, appropriate expected quantity, and right quality. That is very much essential. So this quality, if customers have some expectation regarding quality, and if it is not met, it will lead to dissatisfaction. So here we are closing our session for the day. In the next lecture, we will continue this introductory part. Thank you.